each one of these is going to be a penny's worth of effort. Oh, let's make it a dollar's worth of effort. Why not? A whole dollar's worth of effort. And it's effort involved in picking apples. And these represent my cost as a farmer of picking six apples. All I'm going to talk about is the cost of actually picking the apples. We're going to forget about the interest that I owe the bank and the rent on the farm and the insurance that I pay and the fees and all of that other stuff, all of the fixed costs. All I'm going to vary is the amount of labor, the amount of effort I put into picking an apple. So I want you to imagine an apple tree. And think of yourself as a farmer facing the apple tree. And what are you going to do when you pick your first apple? Is you're going to pick the one that is easiest to get to, closest at hand, right? This one. That takes $2 worth of effort to get. So the marginal cost of my very first apple is $2. And then I want to pick another apple, and my problem is that the easiest one to reach is now gone. It's in my basket. And now I only have the next easiest one to reach, and that's this guy. Four units of effort. So at this point, we can, even without all these other colors, establish what total cost is, total variable cost, marginal cost, and average cost. So let's try it. First thing is, the marginal cost of the first apple was 2, and the marginal cost of the second apple was 4. So my total variable cost is 6. It's my total variable cost because I told you that my labor was the only thing I was going to allow to vary. My mortgage and the insurance and all of that other stuff, that's fixed cost. Whether I pick any apples or I don't pick any apples, I have to pay that. And if all of that put together is $10,000, then my total cost is $10,006. $10,000 of which is fixed, and $6 of which is variable. Now, since fixed cost doesn't really matter in the short run, I'm going to have to pay it whether I pick the apples or not. I'm going to just assume it doesn't exist at all anymore, and I'm just going to focus on variable cost. So here I am, my total fixed cost, I'm just going to assume to be 0, and I have total cost of $6. Well, what's my average cost? At this point, it's blindingly obvious. It's $6 that I spent getting 2 apples. 6 divided by 2. My average cost is $3. And it doesn't matter whether I do it this way, or I do it this way, or make some other kind of weird variation of the Irish flag. But the average just kind of takes everything together and makes it history. We'll see what this has to do with the price of apples that you have to pay in the market later. Right now, it's just cost. That's hard enough. Let's move on to the third apple. The third apple is in the back of the tree a little bit, and I have to reach for it, and oh, that extra strain is just terrible, and it costs me an extra $2. So $2 for the first, $4 for the second, $6 for the third. I'm now up to $12 that I've spent to get 3 apples. $12, 3 apples, an average cost of 4. When I do the average cost, all I do is get, you know, kind of like a pile for each one and even them off as much as I can. 12 divided by 3. Then there's my fourth apple. I had to stick my hand through a spider web for this one. Fourth apple cost me $9. Notice something about this $9. First place, if you hadn't seen it, there would be no way you could tell what the marginal cost of the fourth apple was going to be, except that you could predict that it was going to be greater than 6. Because if it was less than 6, I would have picked that apple first. That is, the marginals have no sense of history. The fourth doesn't really have anything to do with the third. The third doesn't give you any particular predictive power over the fourth. The cost of the fourth apple has absolutely nothing to do with anything except the cost of the fourth apple. It's the average cost that mushes everything together, not the marginal. For the average cost, now I have 4 apples. I've spent $21. Life is getting complicated here, because it's not going to come out even. I have $5.25 left over, basically. It doesn't come out even. Sorry, I cannot take these poor little things and cut them up for you. That would just be too cruel. But it's not going to come out even. But the average includes the really expensive ones you did last and the really cheap ones, all together. And it gets worse and worse and worse. My fifth apple is going to cost me $12 to get my hands on. My sixth apple is going to cost me $16 to get my hands on. Notice I have an upward sloping line, which resembles a marginal cost curve, because that's what it is. It's just a marginal cost curve in little caps. And it should represent a supply curve too, because that's where the supply curve comes from. I'll give you one apple if you give me $2, but if you want 2 apples, you have to make it worth my while to reach the second. And as I have to reach further and further into that tree and stick my hand into spider webs and risk falling off the ladder, etc., you have to throw more and more and more money at me. Now let's see what's happening with total cost. My total cost is going up. Well, the total cost would go up even if each apple cost me the same amount. Let's suppose that the first apple cost me 1, and the second apple cost me another 1, and the third apple cost me another 1, and the fourth apple cost me another 1, and the fifth apple cost me another 1, and the sixth apple cost me another 1, because I have this magic tree that always rotates to put an apple in my hand at the same spot, so all of the apples are the same, my cost would still go up. They'd go up $1, $2, $3, $4, $5, $6. That is, they'd go up at a constant rate because the marginal cost is constant. The rate of growth is constant. And because the marginal cost is positive, the total goes up. But what's going on here is a bit more bad news for any given firm, and that is, however much your cost went up with the last thing you did, it's going to get worse. First apple, my cost went up by 2. Then they went up by 4. Then they went up by 6. My total cost is not only going up, it's going up by more each time. It's going to go up by so much that it's going to go off the screen. And unless I'm extremely lucky, it will topple over. But you notice this thing is growing, not exponentially. Let's not get that technical, because it isn't. But it is growing at an increasing rate. It's growing because marginal cost is positive. It's growing at an increasing rate, getting steeper and steeper, because marginal cost is increasing. Now, where does this leave us with average cost? Well, where this leaves us with average cost is, take them, mix them up, divide them into 6 piles. Don't drop any. That was 2. I'll get them back. And that's your average cost. The average is a hodgepodge. The marginal knows that it's the first. The marginal knows it's the 6th. But the average has the whole history muddled into it.